Hello, you are watching the UseWise channel. My name is Mladen Baranek, CTO of Miadria Group. Today I am going to talk about the intranet versus internet and how this is relevant to the decision about applications and services you want to be using in your company. How to view this when you are considering security and other interesting topics related to this. We are developing UseWise, a platform that will enable companies to use public cloud services from major providers in an easy and automated manner, achieving full coexistence within services provided by various providers. We had several discussions with our clients, and it turned out there is a real need to dive into the topic of intranet versus internet in more details. What is intranet? The basic definition would be that intranet is supposed to be designed to be a private network for applications and services more or less isolated from the internet, an open public network. They overlap in a sense that intranet might be accessible from the public internet, but usually it would be protected with firewalls, proxy servers, and application gateways, so that applications and services are accessible only to internal company authorized users. It sounds like intranet would generally be more secure than the internet. Well, not really. An intranet is by and large a thing of the past. In the past, companies were spending lots of money building their own internal networks and directory services for authenticating users and authorizing access to applications and resources. Big players like Microsoft and IBM were trying to build their own replacement for the internet standards, and this is where this intranet story is coming from. But when you think about intranet security and the recent development of mobile networks and public internet services, everybody is using like email, Google search, and many others. There are more applications outside of the intranet than inside. To make things worse, Active Directory and older security protocols are not compatible with internet applications. They work only with legacy applications and needs to be extended with additional resources to enable access to internet applications. That is exceptionally demanding, and it is up to your resources to take care of it. Security is a tricky thing. If your applications would not survive on the internet and they need intranet for protection, you might be in trouble. And intranet is usually seen in companies with on-premise installations, VPN networks, and some would call it conservative and some would call it outdated view on efficiency and security. On the other hand, a public cloud and possibility to move your workloads to large public cloud providers like Google, Microsoft, or Amazon, to name a few, has opened you to internet and possibility to use security that is at the tip of your fingers. Each time you log in to your services, work productivity, infrastructure, CRM, all those amazing services that are available from these providers. For instance, did you know that Google has one of the largest IP networks that will basically connect you to the Google services closer to your location than you ever realized? Or did you know that they are using artificial intelligence to help with user authentication and authorization? This new view, where you realize the internet and the security of services that you are using is protecting your data, is something that many companies are discovering today. For instance, if you are under attack from hackers, you might be in a position where your intranet will be infiltrated and your data will be subject to their ransom demands. On the other hand, a crypto locker is not really a problem if you are using software as a service, office productivity tools in the cloud. If you want to learn more about the security of Google Cloud, just search. There is extensive documentation that you can go through and see for yourself. Most people will readily assume that intranets are more secure than public networks, such as the internet. However, any network is vulnerable, and money and level of investment into security will play a great role in how secure you will be. There is also one catch 22. If you are using emails and exchanging information in any form with the outside world, then you are open to the internet in many ways. And if you are not using emails, my apologies for assuming it, but if you might as well come to 21st century and start using advanced services in the cloud, the internet, and change the way you view your corporate security. Somebody once said, the only secure computer is one with no power, locked in a room with no user. If you are going for that, I would admit that intranet would be the best solution. This topic might be controversial to some, and I would like to have this discussion with anyone that has any doubts and needs to bounce ideas of somebody. My email is mladen@miadria.com, mladen, and please feel free to contact me. Drop me an email and we can have a video call to talk into more details. Have a great day and thank you for watching.